The Prime Minister of Uganda, Robinah Nabbanja, led a cross-section of ministers and other leaders to the inspection of Guangzhou Dongsong Energy Limited to establish the status of the phosphate exploration and challenges affecting the facility.
When the bank stopped the loan, we also struggled with our own funds until we say we cannot continue like this. Then we stopped manufacturing. But we sold the fertilizer up to end of 2021.
According to Nabbanja, government moves to ensure that the facility is helped to revamp to produce the much-needed fertilizers to enable increased production and productivity in the country.
Uganda is an agricultural country. And we are these days talking in terms of PDA. And we have a lot of hope that our people are going to be as productive as possible. So we need the fertilizers in this camp. So the president directed me to come and inspect and do the monitoring of this facility.
Nabbanja appealed to the people of Tororo and Ugandans in general to support investors because industrialization is a sure way of developing the economy by creating jobs and also facilitating development of the economy.
We don't want you a Lugambo. Lugambo, no. We need actions to see that we assist our investor to move. Nothing else. Madam, I don't even need you to talk. You know we have already had an interaction with you, one-on-one. The president wants to see how to help the people of Tororo. This is for you, the people of Tororo. It is yours. Look what it has been.
Members of parliament from Tororo welcomed the government plan to revamping the defunct facility because of the many advantages that people of Tororo get from the operation of such infrastructure. They called for consideration of the local content as a priority.
To benefit from these so many minerals here in terms of regaining the employment that our people have lost, but also in terms of corporate social responsibility from our development partners, as well as seeing also government inject more of these resources in our roads and also other infrastructures.
Prime Minister, we have a challenge. Whenever an investment or a project like this kickstarts, the people, the host community, are always marginalized in terms of job opportunities.
The Tororo District Chairperson John Okeir welcomed government's intervention of having the plant revitalized because of the economic importance to their community and the entire country.
In the beginning, we were told there's going to be so many industries here. The glass factory, I don't know, vehicles, different. But the people were only seeing fertilizer, and that has disturbed their mind for long. So they need clarity about that. Lastly, as a district, we welcome and embrace the project because of its numerous benefits to the population of Tororo, such as employment opportunity, infrastructure development, as well as improved economic development.
The Premier introduced a cabinet subcommittee led by Dr. Monica Msenero, appointed by President to find mechanisms of addressing challenges that led to the closure of the facility and ensure its revamping as soon as possible. The other members of the committee are the Energy and Ministry of Development, Dr. Ruth Nankabira, her deputy, Okasai Opolot, Minister of State for Defense, Jacob Oboth Oboth, Ogalo Obote, Minister in charge of Teso Affairs, who represent the Prime Minister's office, among others. The committee is expected to make a report to the President within a period of 1 month. Ismail Kasoha for the news.